Hi all, today we are going to discuss about Gauss's law. So what is Gauss's law? This Gauss's law is based on the experimental observation from the Faraday. What the Faraday has done, he has taken one sphere in the laboratory, he has applied a positive charge to this, he has given a positive test charge to this plus Q. So when he is charged, he has taken one more sphere above this, that means this small sphere is kept inside a big sphere. He observed that due to this charge in the inner side sphere, automatically the minus Q is inside in the inner side of the outer sphere, as well as plus Q is induced on the outer side of the outer sphere. Or we can tell that he has observed that when we are keeping a charge Q inside some surface, automatically the amount of the flux lines that are coming out of that surface, the amount of flux lines that are coming out of the surface, this will be equal to the value of the charge that is enclosed. That means he has just observed that the amount of the flux lines is equal to the charge enclosed. And he has also observed that the m value of the charge, this charge can be due to the multiple distributions, either it can be point charge or it can be a line charge, even it can be a surface charge or the volume charge. In all the cases, the amount of the flux lines that are coming out is exactly equal to the total value of the charge that is enclosed inside the surface. If let us assume some different charges are kept, let us assume I have kept plus Q here, let us assume I have kept some value of minus Q, and I have kept one more charge of then plus 2Q, then the net value of the charge that is enclosed will be equal to plus Q plus 2q, that becomes 3q minus q. So total net charge is equal to 2q, or we can tell the value of the flux that is coming out will be equal to 2q. That means it is independent of the location where it is lying inside this surface, closer surface we are taking, and it is independent of even the medium in which these charges are kept. He has observed that it is independent of all these things. Based on this, he has concluded this experimentation as, he has given the definition as the Gauss law. So this Gauss law is a general statement regarding the relationship between electrical flux crossing a closed surface and the charge enclosed by it. This is what he observed from the experiments. So this law does not put any restrictions on the sign or distribution of the charges and shape of the surface enclosing the surface. You can take any type of shape that is enclosing this, the charges. So what does this law statement? So I am just summarizing the law statement. The statement is the total flux crossing any closed surface is equal to the algebraic sum of the charges enclosed by the surface, or we can tell that the flux that is leaving is represented by psi is equal to charge enclosed Q. This is what is proved. To prove this Gauss's law, let us take the example I am taking in the spherical coordinate system. Let us take that the flux density, some charge Q, is lying at the origin of a sphere. So let us take the point P, r comma theta comma phi. I want to find at this point. So at this point, if you want to find the flux density, we know that the flux lines will go out like this from this. So this will be the direction of my the flux density d. This is my direction of my flux density d. Let us assume this is having a distance of r. It is lying at a distance of r. This is my surface is s. In this case, I can calculate the flux density. We have seen in our previous classes, flux density will be equal to, because it depends on the distance only, it becomes Q divided by 4 pi r square. It will be in the direction of ar, because it will be along the radius, because it is a vector. So now the differential surface, that means if you are taking a differential surface at that point, because different type of differential surfaces will be there. If you are taking in the spherical coordinate system, those things are, we will keep one coordinate as constant, take the remaining coordinates. That's why it will be r square sine theta d theta d phi in the direction of ar. How these things come, I have derived in the case of spherical coordinates. So you can please check in numericals on spherical coordinate system. One lecture is there. In that lecture, I have explained. I am leaving the link in the iTab above. Even you can pick up from there if you don't have the idea about how to calculate these things. So plus r sine theta dr d phi in the direction of a phi plus r dr d theta in the direction of a phi. This is the value of differential surface. So we can calculate the value of the flux that is leaving from the small differential surface will be the flux density at that, in that differential surface, dot product with ds, because we have to take what is the direction of d in the normal component direction. That means let us assume the normal component to this surface is, this is my direction of an normal to this surface. So I have to refer this d in the direction of an. That means it will be equal to d cos theta, or simply it is nothing but the dot product of d dot ds, this ds in the surface of, in the direction of an. So this is what you agree with me. So I can substitute this value. I can write my value of d psi will be equal to q divided by 4 pi r square into, because d you can see it is in the direction of ar, dot product will be equal to 1, or the component will remain only if you are multiplying with the same value. So only ar, dot product with ar only will remain, remaining two components will become 0 whenever you are taking the dot product. So I am directly writing this component. So this component is r square sin theta d theta d phi. So now if you want to calculate the total flux coming out of the surface, you have to do the surface integral. So I am closure surface integral, this will become q divided by 4 pi. So integration theta is varying from 0 to pi. Similarly, this phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi, r is constant. So this will become sin theta d theta into d phi, d theta into d phi. So if you calculate this, this will be equal to the charge enclosed. You can just do the integration and substitute, you will get this value as q. So we can tell that the Gauss law is proved, that the total flux that is leaving is equal to charge enclosed only. For this example also it worked. So this Gauss law, it can be generalized. This is called as integral form of the Gauss law. So it can be applied for linear surface or volume charge distributions. Let us take for example, a small volume charge is there which is lying inside. So this volume charge, let us assume a small element in that is dv. So total charge enclosed by this will be equal to rho v dv. So I can write this, the total charge that is enclosed dq is equal to rho v into dv in that small area, or I can calculate my total charge enclosed by this small volume. This volume will be equal to volume integral of rho v dv. Everyone agree with me? Similar way, let us assume I am taking some surface. Some surface area I am taking. That surface area, let us assume it is having some surface as a ds dash, differential surface dash, and surface charge density is rho s. So in that case, the charge enclosed dq will be equal to the differential charge that is enclosed, right? So this I can write as rho s into ds dash, or from this I can calculate q is equal to surface integral of rho s into ds dash. So we have to do the surface integral, everyone agree with me? Same thing is the case for the line integral also. So if there are some line charges existing there, having a line charge of rho l, let us assume the total length is equal to l. So again there also I can calculate my q is equal to line integration of rho l into dl, differential length whatever is there. So using that I can calculate, or otherwise I can tell that volume integral of this rho v dv, because this is the total charge that is enclosed inside. If you are taking any closure surface, the flux coming out of that closed surface will be closure surface integral of d dot ds. So this will be same. So similar way I can tell that surface integral of rho s ds, let us assume that ds, the surface is ds dash, this will be equal to closure surface integral of d dot ds. Remember here, this ds is for the outer closure surface which is enclosing that charge. Similarly, if the line charge is there, we can tell that it will become line charge density. So rho l into dl, integration this gives my charge, this will be equal to flux. Flux is nothing but closure surface integral of d dot ds. So in this way we can calculate for different things. So we are going to solve the numericals, though why I am writing this formulas and other things, it will be clear to you. Now let us see applications of the Gauss law. So Gauss law is used in the calculation of electric field intensity of symmetrical charge distributions, and it is also used for deriving the divergence of electric flux density and for deriving the boundary conditions in both static and time varying fields. So let us take one example to clarify this. So the example is, find the total electric flux leaving the spherical surface which is given by r is equal to 2.5 meters given the charge configuration is given by, different parts are given there, q is equal to 2 to the power of minus x square nano coulombs on the x axis at x is equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2, like that it is distributed up to m. That means it is having a line, it is lying along the x, it is lying at x is equal to 0, another charge is lying at plus 1, another charge is lying at minus 1, similar is the case as plus 2, another charge is lying at minus 2, like this it is extending up to minus m and this is extending up to plus m. So using this, find the total flux that is leaving the spherical surface. I am taking a sphere having a radius of 2.5 meters, how much flux will be leaving, that is asked there. If you calculate this, you will get it value as 2.125. Please check it. I am going to solve this numerical in the next class. You can just work out, so and you can compare with what I have derived. Then next one, a line charge having rho L is equal to 1 by Z square plus 1 nanocoulomb square meter, it is lying along the Z axis. If a charge is lying along the Z axis, so how much flux is leaving the sphere? This is the second one. The answer for that will be 2.381. Similarly, a surface charge rho S is equal to 1 by X square plus Y square plus 4 nanocoulomb square meter square on the Z is equal to 0 plane. So, if a surface charge is also lying, in that case, you will get the answer as 2.956 nanocoulombs. Because solving this takes so much time, so that's why I will solve it in the next class. You can try to solve it. If you are getting the answer, it is fine. Otherwise, you can check with my solution that I am providing in the next class. So, I hope all these things are clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.